I'm leaving now.
Lucy, my sweet.
I cleaned out the tiger cage and sorted all the meal bins. So, if it's all right, it's my turn to fix dinner.
Haven't you forgotten something, little one? Just one little thing?
Mr. Runcer, please.
It's been a very long day.
I don't want to.
Now, Lucy, I thought we'd settled this last week. Don't let's forget who pays your salary. We're closed. Come back tomorrow. Wait! I haven't finished with you. I told you, we're closed.
We're not here to buy, little man. We've come to sell.
You can't possibly have anything to interest me. These are extremely rare animals of the highest quality.
What a coincidence. So am I.
That is the price for humanity.
Oh, please, don't.
And what else might we interest you in today, sir? Perhaps some virtue?
Not my animals, please. I'm begging you.
But what of honor, little man? At what price? Honor.
Oh, my God, no! That tiger is the rarest specimen ever seen.
Tiger, tiger, burning bright. The forest of the night.
BR-61661, report to precinct headquarters, code 3, repeat code 3.
I was just finishing up my 12 out on patrol when I got the call. Welcome relief, considering that the most action I'd seen all night was a schizoid grandmother doing the shimmy in her underwear in the second sector. Last time I had a 3 was when some hooker vomited Thunderbird on Bryant's desk, and yours truly led the cleanup crew. Year and a half on the job, it was still the dirtiest work I'd seen. Where's Captain Bryant?
Took a sick day. Got himself a heinous case of ptomaine poisoning. He asked me personally to run the unit in his absence.
Guzo was one of the old-time guys who took their knocks in the streets. He had a friendly way about him, but you didn't want to turn your back on him if you were less than a friend.
Hope you've been enjoying your leisure time, kid, because it's time to take that thumb out of your ass.
Hallelujah.
Don't get too excited. The other Blade Runners are all jammed up. Holden's sucking dinner through a straw. Gaff's working the Tyrell break-in, and Steele's working special undercover. Looks like you got this one by default.
You really know how to make a girl feel wanted.
Animal murder done at Runciter Zoological. Probably just be a schizoid glitz, but we got the call. Old man Runciter lost something like a billion chinions worth.
10 to 1, this ain't a job for Rep Detect.
You got something better to do? Perfect your French cooking, maybe?
Slumming tonight, Slim?
I thought you were on special assignment.
Wasn't too damn special after I had the suckers out.
What happened?
Couple of fours were masquerading as fibroblast insulators down at Kaiser. I dressed up like a nurse, they never had a chance.
I'll bet. You put them on the machine?
Hell no. There's a beautiful little thing in here called the magic, and it ain't ever been wrong. You develop it, you got a brilliant career ahead of you.
I'm working on it.
What's Guza got you doing tonight?
AM at Runciter's.
Animal murder. Oh, those skin jobs got no respect for anything that truly lives and breathes. And that goddamn Eldon Tyrell ought to be zipped into a body bag and flushed into deep space.
Get rid of him, we'd be out of a job.
I think we're all overdue for a little off-world paid vacation. You can stop staring at my ass now.
You got eyes in the back of your head?
All you gotta do is ask, Slim.
Animal sales was a profitable and prestigious business since most real animals had died out after the Terran War. There were plenty of electric ones, though, powered by rechargeable batteries. No self-respecting human would own one of those frauds.
What do you know?
About 30 counts of animal murder and one of aggravated assault. The shop's been thrashed. You ought to see this tiger cub they got in there. It's a goddamn tragedy.
How's old man Runciter holding up?
State of shock. He's been moaning and complaining about his world caving in.
You'd feel the same way if they were your animals. How many perps?
At least two. Bloody footprints all over the scene.
Must be a delightful sight. Find anything else out here?
Zilcho. Row actions inside. Abstract art. All over the walls and ceiling.
I never did appreciate art.
I already checked for a crowbar, some kind of tool. No luck, but it looks like we've got some latents.
Make sure the lab boys run them through the mainframe, human and rep.
Find something?
Piece of chrome.
From a car?
No, I think it's horse chrome. Bag it and tag it. Canvas the area. Maybe somebody had his eyes open.
I'm on it.
Scratches and paint flecks, and I knew what they meant. Unless the city had bought a jet black fire truck, somebody had a big fat traffic ticket coming. Nothing even remotely interesting, but hell, if I was going to root through trash, my expectations weren't too high. Judging from the distance between the prints, I was looking for two very big men. One dragged his right foot, indicating a possible injury or lameness. The other appeared a lot more controlled, graceful even. Quite a pair.
McCoy, LPD.
I'm absolutely certain Lucy Devlin was involved in this heinous act. She's the young girl who works for me.
She's responsible for all this mayhem?
No, of course not. It was two men acting in concert with her, obviously.
Obviously. What'd they look like?
Big and scary and absolutely malevolent.
Tell me about this Lucy.
There's not a lot I can tell you. She's only worked for me for about a month. She's about 14 years old with pink hair. A very attractive young thing.
How'd you find her?
She came to me with a reference from Ogilvy's in the Northwest Zone. And he's a very reputable wholesaler.
You treat her well?
As well as any young tot should be treated.
She got a desk? Or someplace where she worked?
She used to eat over there. My precious one. She was my baby.
You got any discs from that camera?
It's irrelevant. Those murderers also destroyed the camera. Thousands of chin yens worth.
Maybe it photographed them before they shot it out.
I guess you've got a point at that. I believe this is the disc from last night.
Peachy. See if you can dig up that reference from Ogilvy's.
Yes, it's somewhere here. Just a moment. Here you are. My precious one. She was my baby.
A candy bar. Yuck.
Howie Lee's, in Chinatown. I'd eaten there myself.
Well, isn't that cute?
toy dog. Big caliber, possibly off-world combat weaponry. Ballistics might give me a fix on it.
My precious one. She was my baby.
It didn't add up. Animal murders, the lack of any theft, the small animals alone were worth a good chunk of change on the street. It seemed more like an act of vengeance. Find anything else out here?
This woman says she saw that kid who worked for Runciter hanging around with a big fat guy last week.
Find anything else out here?
This guy lives across the street. Says he heard a crash late last night. Looked out his window and saw a black sedan speeding away from the scene.
Lockup. Ground floor. Mainframe and shooting range. Laboratory. Roof. Mainframe and shooting range.
Violent street crime in the city rose again last year by a whopping 26%, according to the latest figures from the Department of Justice. Governor Kolvig attributed the change to the dramatic increase in the number of specials registered as city residents and promised a tough new set of standards for the City Immigration Bureau by next month.
Lucky Strikes, Crystal's brand. I knew she was spending a lot of time in the training maze these days, even though she'd already gotten close to a perfect score. Old copies of case files, notices, and memos. The usual station junk.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete. Scanning video disk. Two enhanceable images found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. Runciter crime scene.
A sushi menu from Howie Lee's. Give me a hard copy of that. It's some kind of insect. Give me a hard copy of that.
Runciter crime scene.
He looks familiar. Give me a hard copy of that. Local license plate.
Give me a hard copy of that.
Well, if it ain't Ray McCoy! Bryant finally letting you play with the big boys.
My clearance come through?
You bet. You bring your piece?
Don't leave home without it.
Steele's been running the maze every other day for 2 weeks, and the targets are getting a little roughed up.
I thought Guza was gonna requisition some new ones.
I ain't seen him down here in a month. Guess he's been busy.
Poor guy. I bet he gets all tuckered out from pushing those papers around.
And don't sell him short, McCoy. Guza could be one tough hombre. I remember when we worked vice together. He poured acetone on two pimps that gave us some lip and lit a match. I'll tell ya, it looked like the goddamn 4th of July out there.
Peachy. Hit the lock, Jack.
I guess there ain't no harm in it.
Target and shoot all threats. Do not shoot innocents. Confirm target as hostile before shooting.
Laboratory.
Got anything new for me, Dino?
I was wondering when you'd show your mug around here, McCoy. The shell casings from Runciter should be in the Museum of Military History.
How's that?
They're from an Ender rifle. It's standard issue off-world military hardware. Heavy caliber. That puppy can punch right through a tank.
What can I conclude from that?
Whoever used this piece didn't just walk into their local sporting goods store and buy it. Those babies are collectibles, and they ain't cheap.
Anything else?
We got the animal corpses from Runciter's, but there wasn't a whole lot to work with.
Bone marrow?
About 50% were real, the rest were fakes.
So, Runciter was ripping his customers off.
State-of-the-art fakes. Miles beyond the crap you see on Animoid Row.
The kind that comes from legit manufacturers?
Yeah, they're the ones that usually produce the quality.
What about the wounds?
Most of them were shot point blank, but we're looking at some others. Sloppy cuts with a knife, like the perp was really pissed off at something.
Butcher knife?
Could be, but who cuts meat anymore?
Nice bunch of reps I'm tailing. Hope you're not pulling a meat cleaver out of my back next week. Anything else?
That black paint you found on the fire hydrant? It's from a ground car.
You sure?
The angle of impact was almost head-on. And there ain't too many spinner drivers klutzy enough to smack a street-level hydrant in VTOL mode.
I heard your wife got her license back.
You're a real funny guy, McCoy.
Anything else?
That piece of chrome you found outside of Runciter's is from a 1995 Pontiac.
Nice set of wheels.
It's okay, not what I call a classic.
Anything else?
Zip, man. Try me later.
Real sushi was a luxury reserved only for the elite, since most sea life had become radioactive after the Third Terran War. The rest of us had to eat new sushi, soya mixed with off-world lichen.
McCoy, LPD, I want to ask you a couple of questions.
Sorry, my man. I just don't got the time.
Got to mix more out back.
You're a pretty smart-looking cat. Wanna make some money?
Pay me large, you got my rapt attention.
Depends on how much the information's worth.
Unfortunately, my man, I got a bug. Dynamite dining, old man. Catch you later.
Beautiful night, isn't it?
When business thriving, night always beautiful.
This from your place, isn't it?
Could be. Chopstick come from Yoshi's restaurant supply.
How long has that chef worked for you?
Zubin? Just month. Superior chef. Makes all kinds of new sushi.
What's real fresh tonight?
Special shipment of toro just arrived. I fix you right up. No one else. Clean as a whistle.
You're Prince, Howie. This from your place, isn't it?
Yes, sir. You do Howie a favor? Distribute all through our police station?
Howie says you're a master chef.
You not come back here. Air bad.
This'll only take a minute. I'm looking for a girl, about 14 years old with pink hair. You seen her?
I don't know her.
There's a test I'd like you to take. It won't take too long.
Test? What kind of test?
Kind of a personality test. Totally routine.
Routine?
A big guy run past here?
Hey, maybe spare some chinion?
Sorry, pal. All I got are hundreds.
Hey, that'd work.
Rumor has it you've been earning your stripes, McCoy.
Working on it.
Keep it up. You just might have a future in this business.
I understand it's got a hell of a retirement plan.
You VK the mark before retirement?
Didn't have to.
That's why they call it the magic.
I'm starting to understand.
You ever retire a human, your career is over. Remember that. I checked with you and Air. Looks your rep swung that Moonbus massacre last month.
They ever find the Moonbus?
Disappeared into thin air. Brian thinks it crashed out in the Kipple.
How many reps are we talking about?
Enough. They're Nexus Sixes. So don't take too much slack.
Gotcha. Yuck.
Your floor number, please.
McCoy, 88F.
88. Thank you. Thank you.
I lived with the best gal I'd ever seen. She was two now and full of life and love. She'd cost me about a year's salary, but she was worth it. It was good to have someone warm nearby after completing a dirty job, and the retirement swag from this case would go toward getting her a partner.
Here you go, baby. Dinner time.
Zubin was the first Nexus 6 I'd come up against. There was something in his eyes, an almost primordial desire to live. Most of the 3s, 4s, and 5s I'd seen would just give up when you had them. But these 6s, they were a whole other breed.
Portrait of the Sleep Deprived.
Got your delivery here, man.
What?
Kingston Kitchen.
Oh, yes, right. Hold on.
Is this what the gravity be like on Mars?
Oh, no. It's about a third of what we got here on Terra. Real comfy. How about turning that dial, okay? When I say...
Please, can you control your rat?
I'll have you know that Ricky's a purebred chihuahua, and he's totally real.
Things going good at Tyrell Corporation?
Boring, boring. Old man Tyrell's been on a Wagner kick lately. He never shuts up.
You also do outside work?
Sweetie, I never go outside. It's bad for the glands.
How about Nexus 6? You know a lot about them?
I think you should be going now.
Understand good. It holds deep meaning for me now. Where be your research on Nexus 6? And your test studies, contacts, the works?
Only simulator. Extra terrestrial gravity.
One more minute, you be swallowing this explosive. 3 more minutes, they be hosing you off the True Life building across town.
No, I swear. I don't have anything. If I did, I'd give it to you.
My people sick and dying. You tell me something.
Talk to Dr. Tyrell.
Tell me something I don't know.
The organ designers, Miraji, Hannibal Chu, Luther and Lance, they're closer to him than I am.
Where?
DNA Row. They're all working down on DNA Row. No.
You one miserable package man.
No. No, please, don't.
Pick up.
Hope you aren't camped out there with a bottle of tequila.
Oh, very funny.
Early bird slays the worm, McCoy.
Don't worry. I'm up, Lieutenant. What's the buzz?
One of Tyrell's employees got his fat face splattered all over the marble interior of the Tyrell building.
Inside?
That's right. But we also got a sweet little break on it. Tyrell's surveillance system recorded the whole shebang.
Beautiful. How many perps?
Just one. I don't know if it's related to the Runciter deal or not. Tyrell Security will have the disc for you when you get there. You'll be good, killer.
Maggie, come here, girl. Here you go, baby. Dinner time.
floor number, please.
Ground floor. Roof.
McCoy, LPD.
Just a minute.
Where do I go?
Grav test on the east wing, 66th floor. Here's the footage from the security cameras. You get a pretty good look at the man's face.
How'd he get past you guys?
He pretended to be a delivery man. Dr. Eisendoehler ordered in a lot, so it didn't seem unusual.
I may have more questions for you later on.
Yes, sir.
Jesus. I've seen worse, but not by much.
Learn anything?
You could strain him through a sieve.
Obviously, he'd been killed with an explosive, and not just because he'd been plastered on the wall with 1,000 strokes. The detonator wire I pulled out of his skull told the whole story. The killer was an expert. The charge had been big enough to do the job, but not big enough to shatter the soundproof walls of the float chamber. But I wondered why the killer didn't just shoot him. A takeout box from Kingston Kitchens. I'd seen more dead animals than live ones in the last 24 hours, and now it was dogs. Three of them. I thought about Maggie and nearly threw up. The dog collar has a name on it. Ricky, maybe?
You spot anything you think I ought to know about, tell me.
Absolutely.
Someone had tried to access a bunch of protected files on the Tyrell network and failed, not just once, but a dozen times. Tyrell engineers might forget their passwords, but what would the Grav Lab boys need with replicant DNA sequences and incept dates? Eisendoehler had used his dog's name as a password. The Tyrell brass wouldn't be too happy if they knew I was snagging a copy of their files, but someone had wanted them bad enough to kill Eisendoehler, so I figured they must be worth having. It was a Tyrell sales brochure for the Nexus series, the kind of glossy hype that ends up littering the floor at trade shows. This one was for last year's infamous Lolita model, a big hit with the all-important dirty old man market. The earring was shaped like an insect. I didn't know much about jewelry, but it looked like junk to me, like the cheap crap sold at the stands and shops of Animoid Row.
Lagging behind again?
Guza didn't say anything about me working with a partner.
Oh, in a pig's ass, Slim. No, I'm following up on my own. Could be it's linked to this Tyrell debacle.
How's yours connected to mine?
I'm still fitting the pieces together. You know the moon bus massacre that went down last month?
Gaff mentioned something about it.
The rogue skin jobs probably flew to Earth. And one of them is a demolitions expert, similar MO to your Vic upstairs.
Hell of a coincidence.
I'll call you if I find out anything more about your case.
You friendly with Eisendoehler?
Most of the employees I see coming in morning and night, but old Marcus... Dr. Eisendoehler, He almost never left his lab.
He afraid of somebody?
I think it had something to do with the air outside and the germs. I once heard him complain about it.
Smart. What was his job?
Grub test chief engineer. The lab runs tests to see how a replicant would perform in different planetary gravitational fields. That kind of thing. One of the other engineers could tell you more.
How do I get in to see the big boss?
You don't, unless he wants to see you.
Okay. How do I make him want to see me?
Well, you could call his personal assistant.
Who is?
Don't know, offhand.
Yeah, I get the picture. You know anything about Tyrell's computer system?
Security is tight as a drum, if that's what you're asking.
Somebody tried to access restricted data from the terminal in Dr. Eisendahler's office.
But they couldn't get in.
Yeah. Looks like Dr. Tyrell keeps his files safer than he keeps his employees. Do you know if anyone lost an earring like this one lately?
Not one of the employees, that's for sure. The boss enforces a strict dress code around here.
How did Eisendahler's moo-moo fit in?
Hey, you know, company rules only apply to the lesser mortals.
I may have more questions for you later on.
Yes, sir.
During his last election campaign, Governor Kolvig promised a bold new plan of action to clean up the worst regions of the highly toxic debris that surrounds our city, the so-called Kipple. Just how much progress has been made since then? We spoke to the governor just before his weekly meeting with the city council.
Our studies have shown that the Kipple's effect upon Los Angeles is minor. The radiation and toxic waste is contained in relatively small pockets, all miles distant from the city center. Nevertheless, cleaning things up out there is a worthwhile goal, especially with the thousands of specials living on the city fringes. For now, all I can say is that we're looking at several options, and I'm sure everyone will be pleasantly surprised by our final proposal.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete. Scanning video disk. One enhanceable image found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. Tyrell Grav Test Lab.
The earring was shaped like an insect. I didn't know much about jewelry, but it looked like junk to me, like the cheap crap sold at the stands and shops of Animoid Row.
Give me a hard copy of that. A bomb. Give me a hard copy of that. The dog collar has a name on it. Ricky, maybe? Give me a hard copy of that. A takeout box from Kingston Kitchens. Give me a hard copy of that.
ground floor.
Bryant go on permanent leave and you get full use of the office, Lieutenant?
You'd be amazed at how accommodating a man can be after his hemorrhoids get lanced. You really been surprising the troops around here, kid. Gaff says you worked at retirement like a champ.
Just doing the job.
Yeah, well, don't get too cocky. Those sixes can be damn unpredictable.
That I know.
But I'm proud of you, McCoy. Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
Thanks.
Payments is wiring the advance to your account as we speak.
How much?
Couple hundred chinyan. Enough to buy a sandwich or two. We gotta hold back the rest until the lab does the autopsy. Paperwork, you know. Shouldn't take more than a couple of days.
So, the check's in the mail?
Hey, don't worry. The boys upstairs want to keep our best and brightest happy. Any idea what you want to spend it on?
I was thinking maybe a companion for my animal at home.
Forget that. Buy yourself something, something nice. Once you start carving up that juicy bacon, kid, the taste never goes away. The great things in life, believe me, you'll just be wanting more and more.
The goons over at the Tyrell building wouldn't let me talk to their boss. Maybe you can set up a meeting.
Anyone else in that whole company who knows anything?
Huh, you and I both know it's a one-man show over there.
I'll give it a try, kid. I'll have to pull some strings, so don't go in there half-assed. Make sure you got some legit questions for the resident genius.
Appreciate it, Lieutenant.
Get out of here before I throw my desk at you.
Lock up.
Are they letting me out?
I'm not the one who makes that decision.
I suppose it's my turn to bear the cross for the cause.
You're Spencer Gregorian, right?
No. I really think my lawyer should be here.
I got some more questions for you. Tell me about your protest at Tyrell's plant.
I already told that other detective everything. Under duress.
I want to know about the people who were there. The Rastafarian and the Asian guy with the sunglasses.
I didn't know the Rastafarian. The Asian fellow was one of our ex-members. Izo was his name.
How long did you know him for?
Let's see. I met him about 5 years ago. He seemed so smart and balanced. He really wanted to help the replicant people.
Then what?
He started associating with the more militant factions. I was astounded when I heard he was supplying weapons to some of them.
What kind of weapons?
Guns so new that even the police had hardly used them, I heard.
I got some more questions for you. Lot of people involved in your cause, Spencer?
Yes, sir, we're growing fast. As more and more people realize that replicants have cognitive and emotional legitimacy, the Citizens Against Replicant Slavery will spearhead the movement towards...
Save the pitch for someone who gives a shit.
We're peaceful people, Detective. We live by a code that men like you could never understand.
Try me.
2 centuries ago, humans were held in slavery. Brave souls formed an underground railroad.
So, you help replicants escape the city.
I'm talking figuratively, Detective.
Sure you are.
We're not children, Detective. We have resources. The world is changing. People are waking up to the injustices perpetrated by a sick society that you have helped...
A lot of them will wake up dead if reps are allowed to run amok on Terra, jerk. You keeping busy, pal?
Please leave me alone. My migraine's acting up.
Roof.
This your work?
Dragon.
Dragon?
See? Si? Anosoptera. Dragonfly late of the American South Swampland.
You sell jewelry with dragonflies?
Items like that, very special significance. Very rare, senor. A state item. And most likely part of large collection. Person must have plenty of money to obtain a collection.
More than I can afford.
You try Hawker's Circle. Might want to trade for this. With luck, you may find.
If this is from a collection, I'm also looking for the other pieces.
I make you a deal. I found out where to get dragonfly jewelry. Then, you buy a piece, right? For special lady friend? You come back later.
I'll do that.
You take care, chasing the dragon. Handsome man like you has lady friend, of course.
All my girl cares about is food and love.
Oh, how romantic. What is this girl's name?
Maggie.
Maggie. Ah! Maggie, senor. It's perfect, is it not?
It's kind of ugly, but you talk me through it.
Had a 45 blaster under your coat, or you're just happy to be here?
You got good eyes.
They ought to be. They're the only organs of mine that survived the Phobos Wars intact.
Ray McCoy, Rep D-Tech.
Blade Runner, huh? How come I never heard of you?
I just got assigned.
Yeah, I'm kind of buddies with Davey Holden. How's he doing?
Word is he's gonna be okay.
That skin job must have been pretty damn quick getting by Davey like that. He's the best in the business.
He'll be back in the job soon. You sell any off-world stuff, like Ender rifles?
Nah, I ain't seen anything like that in years. Wish I had one, though. The Ender was a real workhorse. Good stopping power, decent rate of fire. You looking? Gonna cost you a bundle, I'm afraid.
Not really. Somebody shot up Runciter's shop with one.
Sucker had it coming. I'm sure of that.
Why's that?
Runciter's always putting on those airs like he's better than everybody else. But he'll do anything for a buck. Sell anything to anybody. That's where I draw the line. If it's suspicious, it's out of here. Got no place at Bullet Bob's.
You know anyone who might sell Ender rifles?
There's one other guy around here who dips into that stuff. Got a pawn shop down the street. Goes by the name of Ezo. But who knows what the real title is?
Ezo, huh? Sounds like you don't like him.
Ezo's okay. He's run the green pawn for a while. We're friendly competitors, I guess. But I don't appreciate his politics.
Yeah?
Rumors, that's all they are. I was out there, Ray. I did my time. 3.5 years worth. And I can tell you, Rep's got no business being down here on Earth, okay?
Yeah. Earth don't deserve them.
Tell me about it. We got standards to uphold down here.
You got any decent ammo for my piece?
You mean the good stuff.
Because I know them police-issue spitballs just don't cut it.
Not these days.
Yeah, I know how it is. If you want to drop a skin job, you need a little extra oomph. I got a few clips around here somewhere. If you got the chin yen for it.
Okay, let's have it. Thanks for your time. Jesus.
Two minutes. That's how much time I give every stranger that wanders in here off the street.
Sell a lot of stuff that way?
I don't encourage browsers. What impresses me are people who know what they want and are not afraid to pay for it.
What's the most expensive thing you got in here?
Value is a relative notion. What's significant to you might be meaningless to me.
And vice versa.
Everything here is guaranteed. The finest, most authentic anyone can.
Let me tell you what I want, and maybe I'll impress you.
All my paperwork is in order.
Doesn't matter. I don't read anyhow. What's your name?
Ezel.
You move a lot of valuable goods through here? Valuable and exotic?
How exotic?
We're talking exceptionally fine jewelry in the shape of a dragonfly.
Ah, they were so majestic. I remember them from my childhood, and that was the last time I've seen them.
It's very important that I find out about this. Can you help me?
If I see something, and you can match whatever my collectors will pay, it's all yours.
Thanks a million. How about off-world assault weapons? You got anything that's a match for these?
I don't deal in anything from the off-world. Much too hard to authenticate.
A man of your expertise could probably tell, though.
I don't even like to have them in here. My friend Shoshana Yuri picked up the Eos Plague from some gunner's space helmet. He was vomiting blood for days.
Ever consort with a group called CARS? C-A-R-S?
CARS. What is that?
Citizens Against Replicant Slavery.
I don't have time for such pursuits.
How about Spencer Gregorian?
The same goes for him, whoever he is.
Funny, because he described you to a T. Even down to that stupid little ponytail you got.
It's called a chomagi.
What would you say if I told you Gregorian named you as one of the people who was there when the Tyrell building blew up?
There's a mistake somewhere along the chain of communication.
So, you're denying all involvement?
I won't lie to you, Detective. There was a time in my life when I might have been involved with such an organization. I actually cared. But now, all I care about is my business. I am nothing but a humble salesman. Perhaps I can interest you in this camera. 100 years ago, it was a cherished item. Whole families sat for portraits.
I've seen plenty of photographs in my time.
Have you ever seen this?
There were off-world rifles here and more. Grenades, explosives, modern rifles, even some police-issue restricted weaponry. Ezo wasn't some small-time fence, but a big-time arms dealer. The exact arms that renegade replicants would be looking for to survive in the big city.
I am not about to have all my hard work obliterated just because you stumbled into my shop, Detective. Westerners need guns and hardware. All I need is will.
Freeze, Yoshi!
Ezo.
Whatever. Been keeping yourself busy?
I'll be out of lockup within the hour.
Your little skin job friend's gonna take up a collection to bail you out, or you got it saved up?
Maybe I got friends in high places.
Yeah, and if my aunt had balls, she'd be my uncle. What are you doing here, Slim?
I was gonna ask you the same thing.
I've been tracking this boy for a week. He thinks he's pretty clever. He's a material witness in a case I'm working. In fact, your best buddy's a replicant, isn't he? The big guy with the dreadlocks. What's his name again?
Hallucinate often?
That's okay. You'll be giving him up to me soon enough. I can handle it from here, Slim. Why don't you go buy yourself a lollipop? Something else to suck on.
Very clever.
But I wasn't trying to be.
I was fresh out of leads. Poking around Hawker's circle had been a waste of time. I had nothing to connect this Ezo character to the Eisendollar murder. But if the replicants had done in one Tyrell scientist, maybe they'd go after another. And the subcontractors down on DNA Row didn't have Tyrell's security to protect them.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete. Hawker's Circle. China Bar.
That guy sure gets around.
Give me a hard copy of that.
What's going on? Who did this?
Help me, sir. Please, help me. It is going to blow. Run! Run!
Hold on. An ambulance will be coming.
You must warn the twins. Up there. Up the stairs.
The twins? Did they do this?
No. Tall man with dreadlocks. The bomber. And another with beard. Piercing eyes.
What did they want?
The DNA information. God, forgive me. I told them about the twins.
Don't shoot.
McCoy, Rep D-Tech, BR-61661.
What do you know about this?
Got a dead man here, victim of an explosion. His name was Miraji. He was able to give me a description of the two perps just before he bought the farm.
Yeah? They skin jobs? Or you just in the right place at the wrong time?
I'm practically waxing their tails, officer. I'm that close. But I don't have a lot of time. You mind,
mopping up here? Just do me a favor and kick some rep ass, okay? It's high time someone got them illegals off the street.
Appreciate it.
This is 32 Sector 3 reporting a homicide, possible act of terrorism.
It was something you didn't see too often. A precise, shaped explosion fashioned for minimum collateral damage. The son of a bitch was a pro. Someone with real munitions expertise. And that expertise could only come with extensive, on-the-job, off-world training.
Locked. No way through here.
The vidphone was one of those old Zenith jobs, the last electronic tech that was still produced on this continent, in Mexico to be exact. No wonder the sucker was on the blink. I recognized the logo on the envelope. It was definitely Runciter's Animal Sales, but I didn't expect to find hundreds of chinion inside. I didn't know what it was for, but I'd bet the farm it wasn't on Runciter's books.
Hello, Luther. Hello, Lance. You have no new messages and one saved voice-only message. Would you like to hear the saved message again?
Absolutely.
Hello, it's J.F. Sebastian. I hope you guys are all right. I tried to talk to Dr. Terrell about your reemployment, but I haven't been able to get through to him yet. He's kinda angry, and you know what a cool customer he is. I don't know what happened between you guys, but I'm still trying. If you want to get together, I'm still at the Bradbury. I'll be here all night.
Message saved automatically. To delete, please state your deletion security number.
Not right now. Thanks.
The pleasure's all ours at Sino Bell.
Thank you.
What you want? I'm busy.
Excuse me.
Deliveries to rare.
LPD, I got a couple of questions.
Talk, always talk. You wait, you no take up time. Busy.
Marcus Eisendollar is dead.
Okay, we talk. Quick, now. What you want?
You were close to Eisendollar?
Eisendollar? No time for him. No go to a lab. Eisendollar test off-world gravity to work important organs. Visual center, you see?
Marcus is dead.
To work hard all night, all day, no stop, no break, no OT.
Did you hear me?
Of course I hear you. You think I'm deaf? Your time more important, huh? Eisendollar dead. Miraji may be dead. You out chasing skirts.
Miraji?
You eat supper with Miraji every night, no fail. Sometimes Chinese, sometimes Indian, sometimes home cooked. Sometimes we go up and eat with twins.
Miraji didn't show. Did you call him?
I knocked. 10 minutes ago, door locked. No answer. Where you come from, huh?
What?
Nothing.
Listen to me.
Busy. You not delivery man. You go away. Distraction all day long. Never stop. Loud noises on the street. Beep, beep, boom, 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 boom. Always make me drop eyes.
That'd be dermo design burning to the ground.
Oh? What of Marathi?
He didn't make it.
You leave now, okay? Very busy. Must work.
Miraji's some kind of DNA designer?
Yeah, subcontractor like me. He funny though, like old movies. Miraji master chef. Twins go crazy when he cooks.
You mentioned twins.
Yes. Luther and Lance, Siamese twins, live about Miraji.
They're genetic designers?
Were. Till last month. Got the boot, shit can.
From who?
Big boss, who else? And if I didn't tell you go ask them. I waste no more time. You think I nose around everybody's business, huh?
What about this Lance? What kind of guy is he?
Why, he like Luther, only different. Don't know which.
That's so?
One long hair, talk a lot, always make deal. Other more quiet, work much harder.
What kind of deals?
Sell this, sell that, no matter what weather. Like salesman. Very hard to take, no trust, no way.
Did Lance sell something to Runciter?
Who? Never heard of Runciter. No time for charades. Sound like this, sound like that, look like this.
What's Sebastian been up to lately?
Sebastian? He do what always do, nervous system. Very important to Dr. Terrell.
Where do I find him?
He at old building down alley. Bradbury Hotel, I think. You walk down alley, you find it.
Sorry to bother you.
It was some kind of freakish toy, half mechanical, half organic, rep technology for sure, but no one was going to give me any retirement bonus for it.
Resuming interrupted print job.
DNA research, incept dates, a lot of jargon, but I'd bet my spinner it was valuable to somebody.
Enough!
Oh, you think he found us, man?
One of the design subcons must have talked. Unstable personalities, to say the least.
Told you we should have blown up the old block.
It would have created problems down the line.
We got problem now, man.
This one? He's not a problem. He's an opportunity. You're weak, my friend. I expected so much more from you.
I'm thinking our brother not hearing too good.
Oh, he hears us. Isn't that right, McCoy?
You ready to give up fruitless nightmare man? Come back to family?
He doesn't have a choice. He never did.
Let me kill him, man.
No.
We got no time to be patient. The girl, she's sick. She no gonna get no better.
That's where you're wrong, Sadiq. She will live.
Maybe. But this one, he got it coming bad.
Believe me, he's the least of our problems.
You're talking crazy. The hunter be dangerous.
A fool sees not the same tree a wise man sees.
I'm no fool, man.
You must have a little faith, my friend. Without contraries is no progression.
How can you trust any of their kind?
We have been manipulated by them, correct? Now they're going to see exactly what lies on the other side of the horizon.
Catch me if you can!
How long have I been here, Lucy?
How do you know my name?
I saw your things at Runciter's. Did you feel bad when they killed those animals?
They were so pretty and sweet. I hoped Father wouldn't do it. But Mr. Runciter deserved retribution. That's what Father said.
Why?
'Cause he treated me bad, like I belonged to him.
I'm sorry.
Are you really the hunter, like Father says?
It's my job.
Why? What do you have against us?
Nothing, it's just the law.
Would you hurt me?
I promise you I won't.
Father will be back soon.
It felt and smelled like real cheese. Dairy products were choice contraband, scarce and mucho expensive. Selling them was a Class A felony. Hysteria Hall was an arcade down near Nightclub Row.
Strange. Nothing else there.
You let him in my room?
They had a warrant, mister. What was I supposed to do?
They took my pictures.
Couldn't stop them.
How about me? You think I'm easy to stop? Who the hell are you?
McCoy, LPD.
LPD, huh? Maybe you guys can return something to me.
How do you know we got it?
One of your own. Invaded my property. Bad haircut. Stupid coat. The other guy.
What other guy?
Don't play dumb.
What about him?
Nothing. I just thought you were gonna arrest me, that's all.
I don't care about your little run-in with the manager, okay? I'm looking for a couple of replicants.
Can't help you there, friend.
Maybe the clerk can tell me who was renting that room back there. Why were you hassling him?
He let these creeps in my room. I'm a very private person.
What have they got against you?
Nothing, friend. I ain't done nothing.
We're all innocents, aren't we?
Damn straight. And I don't like people asking questions either.
Just help me out here a little more. You seen a big Rasta guy around here? Or a guy with a beard and dark eyes?
A Rasta? What's that?
He's got dreadlocks. Talks with an accent.
Oh. No, I ain't seen no one like that. Look, my mother's waiting for me. You stick around. Maybe the manager will come back.
I didn't know who was working this side of the pool, but whoever it was, they'd been pretty thorough going through the joint. I doubted if there was anything I could find that hadn't already been snagged and bagged. The car looked a lot like the one I'd been tracking. The driver had been smart enough to pull the license plate, but the vehicle identification number was still there. If I ran it through the mainframe back at the station, I could ID the owner. The wrapper was from a vendor I knew. Best Lycan dogs in the fourth sector. That wasn't saying a whole lot, but with an arcade next door and a dozen nightclubs down the street, Mia and Murray's stand saw more action in a night than my spinster aunt saw all last century.
It was the trickster. He said Pat doesn't have a mink coat. She's got a good Republican court coat. That's all.
You're wrong, sweetie. It was Herbert Hoover.
I'm sorry, but I was there.
Well, if anything, you were all of 3 years old back then.
I still remember it, like it was yesterday.
And he said fur coat, not mink. I saw it on the Discovery disc.
You guys still battling it out?
That's what keeps a marriage alive and kicking, Ray. What can we do you for?
The works.
Coming right up. You know anything about politics, Ray? Famous quotes, things like that?
I try not to.
How about the Checker speech?
Never heard of it.
Well, Hoover's Checker speech.
Nixon's Checker speech.
You're forgetting a lot, your old age.
Right behind you, lady.
You seen a girl around here, about 14, with pink hair? Maybe in the arcade.
I was 14 with pink hair once. A long time ago.
Don't think he means you.
Of course not. Not now. We work outside Hysteria Hall, don't we? Well, we must see 20, 30 girls a day with pink hair.
And every other color in the rainbow.
I found this wrapper.
Yeah, that's from one of our dogs.
You know where I could score some cheese? Like this stuff?
Boy, don't flesh that around here.
He's the police, sweetie.
Besides, the kids today just as soon twist a knife in your backside as to ask Virginian for the tram home. Show that cheese around here, you become a marked man.
Who sells it?
Now, we aren't asking for any trouble, eh?
I'm not working, Bunko. I just want some information.
That nutty broad who runs Kingston Kitchen. She's always bragging about her special ingredient.
That stew she makes, it always did taste a little gamey.
And she charges an arm and leg for it, too.
Be good, you two. You know who deals in insects down here?
You don't want insects? They're no good companion. But fish. Fish are good. I have every kind of fish for you. Blowfish, dorado, miniature sailfish. Very friendly.
No, thanks. I got a dog at home.
Fish just as good as dog.
No, my dog is real.
Real? Oh, you must make lots of money.
Let's get back to insects. Official LPD business.
Down at end of Animal Row, you see big green sign? You try there. Good luck with dog, friend. Hope he stays healthy.
She. Is this scale from a fish?
Same as other one. Not fish. Snake scale.
What other one?
Other police show me scale from same snake. I send him to Abdul Hassan.
How could you tell I was police?
Both of you walking around look confused, like you in wrong place.
Anything unusual happening down here?
I haven't heard much. All been very quiet.
Any luck finding more of that dragonfly jewelry?
Oh, see. I was right. Piece you showed me was part of a collection. Bought for a nightclub in 4th Sector.
You know the name of the nightclub owner?
No, senor. But my friend, he says the man is not selling.
Thanks for your help. How's business?
Good. Very good. Holidays coming soon. Everyone wants insects.
Yeah, I can't imagine a better stocking stuffer.
Step up, step up. Mama Isabella cook you something special. Put a glow in your cheek.
McCoy, LPD. Mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
questions, they always need answers.
This guy work for you?
No, but I wish he do. He be one fine-looking man.
You sure? Never seen him before.
I'd remembered him for sure.
You send a lot of deliveries over to Marcus Eisendollar at the Tyrell building?
Eisendollar? Oh, Eisendollar, yeah! Let me tell you, that man can't eat!
Send anything over lately?
No, sir. No deliveries to him no more. Not since last month. He be way behind on his bill.
Not for a month, eh?
At least. No more till him pay up.
You may have a little trouble collecting. He's dead. Mia and Murray tell me you're using cheese in your stew. Real cheese.
Dim old buzzards. What they know?
I could take a sample of that stew you're cooking back to the lab and have it tested.
Why you pick on Mama Isabella? I never do you no harm.
Where'd you get it?
My sister. She got connections.
Where can I find her?
She back in Jamaica, man. Far away from here. She send me cheese once, maybe twice a month. You know, funny thing you asking about the cheese. Last week, this ugly little man, he run by, grab whole box of empty takeout cartons right off the counter. Police next door, they just laugh. Say the guy not be so happy when he opened them cartons.
What's that have to do with the cheese?
Cheese hidden in that box, man. Keeping it safe till I cook up a new batch. So how could I tell police to bring back box? They find cheese, they shut me down.
This guy who robbed you, what did he look like?
Short. Real short. Bad clothes. Colors way too bright. Funny bow tie. Maybe you look for this ugly little thief, yeah? I'm thinking you not really care about the cheese.
You're right, but I still think you ought to get yourself a different secret ingredient.
You bet, man. That cheese been nothing but trouble for Mama Isabella.
That stew's looking tasty.
Fix your right up. Only dirty chinion. It put a spring in your step, man. The ladies, they be loving you.
Thanks for your time. Does this badge mean anything to you?
Uploading personal clue database.
The mainframe confirmed what I'd already guessed. The car from Chinatown was the same vehicle that had smacked the hydrant at Runciter's. The car was registered to a woman named Dektora. She'd bought it from a used car lot in the 4th sector. I ran the name through records and came up empty. The used car lot checked out clean too, but maybe the owner could tell me something.
Bus.
That guy sure gets around. Give me a hard copy of that. Give me a hard copy of that. That can't be me. Give me a hard copy of that.
It's a killer, I kid you not. Only 35 thou. Yeah, red, orange, blue, puke green, any color you want. Just give me 24 to hose the graffiti off. Just kidding. Ask for the man, Crazy Legs Larry. Toodaloo. Admiring that bishy cat, ain't you? I don't blame you. It's a classic ride in a deluxe sport package. It'll push 125 without so much as a shake. Of course, you gotta find the road for it.
That's always the problem.
Crazy Legs, Larry Hirsch. Pleased to meet you.
Ray McCoy.
You can call me Crazy, you can call me Larry. You can even call me Crazy Legs Larry. But don't call me if you don't think a hot set of wheels ain't necessary.
Okay.
The Bishi's exceptional. Mechanical as Pacific Rim flawless, as usual. But they also save some of the classic styling of the old GM days.
Looks like a piece of work.
Forget those fibroplast Filipino heaps everyone's driving around. This is real. Just feast your eyes on this. You see it? You see it? That's actual chrome, the real stuff. They saved a couple hundred sheets of Tijuana chrome from before the war. It's completely legal and everything. Beautiful, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever seen it before.
And you probably won't ever see it again unless you steal this puppy. And honestly, no. Frankly, I gotta tell you, it's got your name written all over it. Ray McCovey.
McCoy.
Give it, take a couple letters.
I'll have to think about it.
But don't think too long or too hard about it, Roy. It's liable to be gonzo by the time you come back.
Gotcha. You sell a black sedan a few days ago?
Black sedan? Hey, I got standards. If it ain't sporty, I got no room for it.
I've seen the registration. I know a woman bought it from you.
Oh, that sedan. Hey, look, a sexy blonde wants to pay top dollar for the ugliest car in the place. Who am I to say no?
Did you know who she was?
No, but I'd like to know her in the biblical sense, if you catch what I'm saying. Look, Ray, it ain't a crime for me to make a living.
I hope you got paperwork for all these vehicles.
Are we kids or what, Ray? You're talking to Crazy Legs Larry Hirsch here.
I take that as a yes.
You can take it any way you want. Just don't take it for a test drive in the fourth sector. Hey, Ray, how you doing?
Just fine, Crazy.
You've been thinking about the caddy, haven't you? I don't blame you. She keeps me up at night, too. And I ain't ever even lip-wrestled in the back seat. Which is definitely what's in the cards for a stud of your caliber.
Throw in a babe and maybe you got a deal.
No sweat, I'll have one over in a jiffy.
No, just kidding.
Beautiful, isn't it?
The owl or the view?
Both.
The view's amazing. The owl, well, artificial things never did that much for me.
It's a flawless replica. We used a real one as a model.
Owls are extinct. Who told you the model was real?
Dr. Terrell.
He's wrong, or lying. Check your Sydneys.
Eldon wouldn't make up something like that.
You're Tyrell's assistant?
Yes, I'm Rachel. Dr. Terrell is very busy. I'm fully familiar with all Terrell operations.
He does know I'm a cop, right? Blade Runner unit?
Dr. Terrell has already met with one Blade Runner today and has important business to attend to. Your department should coordinate its efforts better.
Yeah, but...
You may speak to me, or you may leave. I can't offer you any other choices.
Fair enough. I wanted to ask about Marcus Eisendeller.
I can't tell you who killed him, if that's what you're asking.
We've already got a suspect. What I want to know is why the killer would be interested in replicant DNA information.
That's a stupid question.
Oh yeah? Why's that?
Your suspect is obviously a replicant, a very dangerous one.
I thought replicants were safe, more human than human. Isn't Dr. Tyrell pushing to make it legal to use rep labor to clean up the kipple?
Are we here to discuss corporate policy or Marcus Eisendeller's murder?
A little of both. You heard about the moon bus hijacking. Yeah, I guess you would have. 50 people dead.
You can't blame.
I'm surprised you aren't out doing spin control. The public gets nervous when your pets wander around the city without a leash.
Replicants aren't pets.
Right. Pets live longer and don't go around killing people.
There are safeguards in the design.
Yeah, I've seen the data. Implanted memories, a 4-year lifespan. I'd probably get a little crazy too, but I don't think I'd start killing people.
Wouldn't you?
As I explained to Mr. Deckard earlier, I've given the Nexus 6 model a past. I've given it the purity and innocence of childhood. And all the joy and despair that comes with a real existence. That's hardly a death sentence. That's life.
I thought you weren't meeting with any more Blade Runners today.
Well, I decided to make an exception. Mr., McCoy, isn't it? You do understand the need for the Nexus 6 to have an identity.
Not really. No. I do see why a replicant who has an identity would want to steal Eisendeller's files.
Please, enlighten me.
They want more life.
They're wasting their time.
They're gonna come for you, just like they came for Eisendeller.
I have nothing to fear from any of my children. I'd tell them all exactly what I told you. Have I given you what you came here for?
I'm not sure. Yeah, maybe.
Then if you'll excuse me, I have a stockholder meeting to attend.
Yes?
I'm looking for J.F. Sebastian.
That's me.
McCoy, LPD. You had a break-in?
I don't think I called anyone.
I was already here. I was chasing one of the perpetrators.
Well, everything's all right now. I'm pretty sure I can handle it.
You may think you can, but believe me, you can't.
Better if I check it out.
Well, if you insist. I don't think they took anything. I don't really have anything here of any value.
You work for Tyrell Corporation?
Yes, sir. I'm one of the principal design engineers for Dr. Tyrell. He's a very nice man. You know, he even fronted me the money to buy this building. It's a landmark, you know. You really should see the front edifice. They put some amazing detail into it.
You feeling all right?
Oh, sure. I'm fine.
You wouldn't be hiding anybody, would you?
No, sir. There's nobody here but me and my friends.
What friends?
Good evening, Gia.
Evening, General. See? I make friends.
He almost looks real.
He's plenty real enough for me. And real good company, too.
Look, I gotta check the premises again. Maybe they left something behind.
Well, if you want to take a look, go on ahead. I can't stop you. But please be careful in my lab.
You got it. You know the design subcons down in the row, Miraji and Chu?
I've heard of them, but I've never seen them. I don't go in for the parties and stuff, and I never go down to the row.
You ever work with a Dr. Eisendoller?
We're in different fields. I'm in basic biogenetic design, and he works on the practical application of off-world physics. He seems to be a very nice man.
Who happens to be dead.
Dead?
He was murdered, probably by a replicant.
But replicants aren't allowed on Terra.
But they're here, nonetheless. And who do you think they'll start looking for next? How well do you know Dr. Tyrell?
Oh, I'm not sure anyone really knows him. But I can tell you this, he's a great man, and a brilliant genetic designer. Dr. Tyrell and I play chess every week. I've only beaten him once.
What do you think the deal was with Runciter and the twins?
Deal? I don't think I understand.
Runciter was paying the twins for something. I saw the cash hidden inside a statue.
How would I know?
Come on, Sebastian. I heard you on the machine. You guys are buddies, right?
There were rumors that the twins were selling some of the animal prototypes to him.
You think that had something to do with their being fired?
Dr. Tyrell doesn't like anyone going around behind his back.
So, Tyrell would really be pissed if he knew Luther and Lance were helping renegade replicants.
You're a Blade Runner, aren't you?
Bingo.
But you said you were here about the burglary.
The guys who broke in might be replicants.
What in the world would a replicant want from me?
You worked on the Nexus 6 series, didn't you?
Just a little bit.
Would you say that the 6s are smarter than the old 4s and 5s?
They're supposed to be. Stronger and more agile, too.
So, maybe they want to learn more about themselves. Maybe they want to pick your brain about their brains.
I think you should leave now, Mr. McCoy.
Got the straight scoop for me, or what?
I think you should leave now, Mr. McCoy.
You're sick, Lucy.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Father told me to watch out for you.
I'm not gonna hurt you.
Have you always lived on Terra?
Yes.
I always dreamed Terra would be so special and beautiful. Birds and flowers and trees and blue water. like on the video. So different from everything on, well, where I was.
Can you take me to your father?
I don't think he'd like that. I don't know where he is, anyway.
There's another hunter after your family.
We know. The woman who smokes.
You've got to get out of here.
You're a good man.
Don't jump to any conclusions.
You're gentle. Father used to be like that, too. He would read to me and tell me stories. Pretty stories, so I would have pretty dreams.
He doesn't do that anymore?
He's out with Sadiq every night. And he and Mother, they argue about what we're going to do. He's worried about her. She hasn't been well lately.
That must be tough on you.
I've seen death before. But the other day, I was thinking, if a person could feel love, real love, for even just one day, I think it would all be worth it.
I agree.
Out in a place with trees and a lake and flowers. I've seen places like that in books.
You'll see them with your own eyes one day.
You're not the hunter anymore?
Go, quickly.
Thank you.
Hey, man.
You're that cat from Howie Lee's. McCoy, right? We keep bumping into each other. You want an autograph? I know you ain't heard of me yet, but Gordo Frizz's autograph's gonna be worth a pile of chinyon someday.
I'll hold my breath. I'm gonna ask you a few questions.
Man, don't you got anything better to do than hassle innocent people at their place of work? Make it snappy, okay?
I really appreciate your patience. You know the chef at Howie's?
That big, flabby guy? Never seen him before.
You were hanging around right when he took off.
Pure coincidence. You are one hell of a suspicious cat, McCoy. Kick back, relax, watch my show. Take a little break from your boring existence. Everybody having a good time tonight? What does a marriage and a tornado have in common? First, there's a lot of sucking and blowing, and then you lose your house. You know what my first wife's nickname was? Twister. The doctor calls up his patient. I got bad news and I got worse news. The bad news is you only got 24 hours to live. The patient says, what could be worse than that? The doctor says, I've been trying to reach you since yesterday. Guess what happens to a replicant who does his job really well? Early retirement, baby. I see we got a celebrity in the audience. Can I get a spot, please? That's right. It's one of the boys from the local Blade Runner unit. One of the LPD's finest, Ray McCoy. Let's give a big hand for Rep Detect McCoy. He's protecting us poor slobs, ladies and gentlemen. He even thinks you're a replicant. He can waste you right where you stand. Nice job, eh, detective?
It doesn't quite work that way.
Doesn't, eh? What if I pretended to be a replicant?
That's just an excuse for your lousy act, Gordo.
That snake dancer that worked here, Zora, she was a rep. And her picture's gonna be on every front page tomorrow.
Too bad she'll never read it.
How are you sure someone's a rep, detective?
There's a test.
Test? What replicant's gonna sit still for a test?
If I'm trying to question someone and he runs, that's a pretty good sign.
Could be a pretty good sign that you need to bathe more often. Do what you gotta do, McCoy. If you gotta shoot, that's cool. Come on, McCoy. Why don't you make me famous?
Get off it. You're no replicant.
How do you know? I could be a martyr for the cause, baby.
Every rep I've ever seen wants to live, not die, pal.
What are you, an expert?
I've been around. You may not be a rep, but you're a damn rep sympathizer for sure. Now we're gonna take a little ride downtown.
Yeah? And what? You'll put me on that Voight Kampf machine? My 15 minutes of fame, baby. It ain't as good as being gunned down in the streets, but what the hell.
You keeping busy, pal?
Show's over, baby! And there ain't gonna be no encore!
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete.
Roof.
I remember Early Q used to call himself a humanitarian because he'd recruit orphans for a sex club, then donate a percentage of their salary to his favorite animal propagation lab. Yeah, he was a real piece of work.
Hey, Hanoi, where's Early?
Off World Fat Farm.
You can do better than that.
No, it's true. Mr. Q sent me a vid just yesterday. Getting the hell of a tan he is.
Early's waiting on me.
Sod off. You've got no appointment and you've got no warrant. This here's reserved for VIPs.
But that's my name, Vip.
You're a real cute boyo.
early. How's it hanging?
Pig slick and hard as a brick. How's yours, General?
Your man gave me a hard time out there.
Yeah, I like Hanoi, but I can't deny his sphincter's a little tight.
What's on tap tonight?
Classy shows all evening, General. You're going to be able to cut diamonds down there or your money back.
You buy some jewelry at an auction recently? Real old, elite stuff?
Who's asking? You ain't with robbery homicide?
No, sir.
Those pieces ain't hot. I got the papers to prove it. I picked them up at legitimate auction. Cost me nearly a pound of flesh, too.
You give this stuff to a girlfriend early?
You kidding? I ain't that stupid. No. I was letting one of my dancers use the stuff in her act. Kind of a tribute to the ancient swamp land, you know what I mean?
Which dancer?
Heck, Eva. She's going on in a few. She's one of my biggest earners, too. She ain't in any trouble now, is she?
Not yet.
Good. Wouldn't want to slaughter the goose that lays them golden eggs.
Hey, early.
I'm working right now, General. Ask me later.
What's your name?
Gentlemen, yours truly, the ever-ebullient Early Q presents the wondrous, mysterious Hecuba, singing and performing the sacred ten-utmost dance of the ancient swamp.
You got a minute, pal?
Sod off, McCoy. I've got no time for you.
That's strange. I didn't hear a knock.
I just wanted to say, wow, you were awe-inspiring.
Well, thank you very much, Mr...
McCoy. Ray McCoy.
Is there something I can do for you, Mr. McCoy?
How do you like working for Early Q?
He's always treated me very well.
Ever see him hanging out with any unsavory types?
We don't get many priests in here, if that's what you mean.
That's such an unusual belt. Is it antique?
They say it's from the last century. Those little creatures have always been my favorites.
Dragonflies?
Yes. And the whole class that contains them.
Tell you the truth, I'm from the LPD. I'd like to ask you a few questions if I could.
Is this about Early Q? Because I could tell you...
Did any other pieces come with the belt?
I'm sure I don't know what you mean.
You buy a vehicle lately? A black sedan?
I wasn't aware that was a crime.
Buying the car isn't. Using the car in an animal murder, well...
Animal murder? That's horrible. I haven't seen the car for 2 days. It was stolen the day after I bought it.
Is that right? Any reason you didn't tell me that right off?
You didn't ask.
Animal murder's pretty horrible.
Yes. Any murder is horrible. And unfortunate.
Some are worse than others.
But death's the same for all.
No argument there. There's a little test I'd like you to take.
Do you think I'm a replicant? Is that what this is about? If it's Early Q, I'll help you any way you want.
Not exactly.
This is insane.
I have a family, a daughter, for heaven's sake. Look, I'm willing to testify against Early Q. A replicant wouldn't do that, would it?
A replicant doesn't necessarily care about what happens to another replicant.
Then you must be a replicant.
I'm sure I'm not.
How do you know you're not a replicant? Did you ever take that test yourself?
Sure I did. Long time ago.
Don't replicants go around with false memories? Maybe somewhere along the line you killed a human, took his place, and your superiors don't even know about it.
Interesting idea. But I'm still gonna give you the test. Reaction time is a factor in this, so please pay attention. Where do you live?
I don't see why you need to know that.
You're crying. Why is that?
No, I'm not.
It's just a hypothetical situation.
I don't know. I suppose I'm unhappy. Perhaps someone has died. I don't cry very often.
Your child comes home with a black eye.
I'd ask him who did it, and I'd call the boy's mother.
You're giving a speech to a crowd of hundreds. First, one person starts to laugh. He leans over and says something to the people around him. Soon, the whole audience is roaring with laughter and pointing at you.
I told you, they wouldn't be laughing.
Why's that?
That's not the reaction I provoke in an audience. You should know. I saw you out there, hiding in the dark with the rest of them.
I ain't the one being tested.
When I'm in front of an audience, I'm the one who's laughing. At every pathetic one of them.
You rent a mountain cabin. On the walls, someone has hung old maps and Currier and Ives prints.
What are those?
Nature art. A deer's head is mounted above the fireplace. A full stag with developed horns.
Why would anyone hang a head on the wall? It was a different time then, wasn't it?
You saying that makes it okay?
Of course not.
You're watching an old movie. It shows a banquet in progress. The guests are enjoying raw oysters. The entree consists of boiled dog.
I'd walk out.
You're going to die. It may be soon. Death. The grave. Rot. It may be soon. The readouts don't lie. You're scared. Don't worry. I won't tell anyone.
Now I know you don't write these questions. You don't really expect an answer, do you?
Got one. Thanks.
Test terminated.
I get it. You're some kind of sexual deviant. I'm finished with you. Get me the police.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, this is an emergency. Early Q's backstage. A customer is harassing me. Thank you.
Put that away. I'm a cop.
Now we wait. If your hand moves, I'll shoot.
Okay.
Please don't talk. The sound of your voice grates on my nerves.
We waited there for a few minutes. Her gun in her eyes never wavered. Any other mark, I'd have been a dead man. But if she was a replicant, she must not have known it if she was willing to call the police.
This a troublemaker? Put your hands on top of your head.
That's right. Ray McCoy, Rep Detect, BR61661.
Never heard of you.
I report to Lieutenant Guza. Call him.
I work for you? Let's go.
Where's your squad car?
Shut your mouth.
Which precinct are we going to?
I'll tell you which one.
This was no precinct house I'd ever been in, and I thought I'd been in them all. The grunt to my right had the beefy, harnessed bull look down pat, and his twitchy partner in the suit looked like he was just itching to chainsaw a couple of kneecaps. Other than that, everything was hunky-dory.
Impersonating a police officer, huh? I guess the new Nexus models are a little more creative than the old ones.
I'm a Blade Runner. You don't believe me? Call Lieutenant Guza.
There ain't no Guza in the LPD.
Unless I've been walking around in a dream, there is.
That's what always bugs me. Yeah, the fact that these skin jobs always gotta live someone else's life.
No shit.
Just make the call, dammit. You're just a piece of shit rep with memory implants of this Guza guy, you understand?
That's impossible.
Rep ain't sounding so creative now.
You want to avoid comp me? Be my guest.
Oh, very good. Very good. Very convincing. Where you been hiding? The kipple? Gregorian bring you in? Who else is working that side of the pool these days?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What about that bastard selling all that stuff downtown?
Hey, shut your trap. I'll tell you something, McCoy. I don't even care how you go out, but I know you can feel pain. And on that account, I'm your man, see? You tell me about everyone you met through cars, and I'll guarantee you we'll go real easy.
Your breath smells like you wiped your ass with your teeth.
You're gonna wish you was neck deep in an off-world reactor vessel by the time I get through with you. Fire up the chair, Holly. You know what I'm gonna come back as in my next life? A priest. There's something holy about how good I am at this.
Freeze! Don't even go for it!
You got any idea how glad I am to see you?
No time for chit-chat, Slim. You want to save your ass, we gotta blow this joint right now. What the hell took you so long?
Good thing you made your entrance when you did.
Good thing one of my snitches saw them escort you out of the club. Otherwise, you'd be three quarters in the bag right now.
They must have been phony cops, hired by the reps for protection.
Cops, yes. Phony, no. I remembered Baker. He used to be an SID expert on coercive technique until he was fired from the force a couple years ago.
A mercenary?
Bingo.
He won't have to worry about getting paid no more.
That stripper you interviewed, she's one of them. Figure it out. She must have made the call to Baker and that other bozo. Let's attend to some business.
I'm there.
Nice crowd.
Regular folks steal, just like you and me.
Speak for yourself. You see it anywhere?
Not yet. You sure she's in here?
I'm gonna look backstage. Check the balcony and cover the exit. I want this one giving us the blow-off.
Never seek to tell thy love, love that never told can be. Poetry. Was running into a lot of that crap lately.
I lucked out. The receipt for the dragonfly collection was right on top of the pile. There were three pieces, a belt, earrings, and an anklet. Early had bought them last month at an auction for more money than I'd see if I retired a dozen reps. I didn't know what was on the disc, but the way Early had hidden it, it was bound to be dirty laundry.
How you doing, General? You got a warrant to show me? You just breaking and entering.
What's on the disc, Early?
Hey, I don't hassle you about your private life. Put it down, McCoy.
Must be something pretty juicy. Your girls know about the cameras?
I gotcha. You want to trade the disc for what?
Let's hear what you got.
What do you say you and I have a drink first, Well, it's your lucky day, McCoy. You're in the garden of earthly delight. See, I bet we can find something to wet your wick.
Not interested.
Bull, everyone's interested.
I want information.
You can have whatever your little heart desires, General.
Whoa!
Cough up some dirt, Early, or I'm taking this disc downtown.
You want Dektora, is that it? The girl with the rep friends? I can give her up. It'd be a hell of a score for you, General. 4, maybe 5 skin jobs.
Sit down.
I'll throw in a night with one of my dancers.
Sit down.
We got a deal or not?
Let's hear what you got.
And then I get the disc?
We'll see. I still got the gun.
You're cold, General. But I know you're gonna be thankful I put those cameras in. Hey, check out Dektora's bearded boy toy. He's here all the time. You can be sure he ain't coming around for the witty conversation.
I've seen him before. What makes you think he's a replicant?
They walked right by my dancers. Didn't even pop a stiffy.
Maybe he swings another way.
Oh, come on, McCoy. Have you seen my girls? Besides, I heard him talking to Dektora. They got friends who are going to help him get off-world. I'm telling you, they got a whole little replicant love fest going on.
You hear him say anything else?
No, General. I ain't the nosy type.
Yeah, you're a model citizen.
You still have something in mind?
The disc? I'm keeping it for now.
We had a deal.
You'll get it back if you behave.
So it's blackmail.
Insurance.
No more free drinks for you, buddy boy.
I didn't get free drinks before.
Get out of my club.
Uploading personal clue database. Downloading mainframe clue database. Clue database transfer complete. Scanning video disk. 1 enhanceable image found. Adding enhanceable photographs to Kaya database. Moon bus. Early Q's nightclub.
Hello there, Lucy.
Give me a hard copy of that.
Early Q's nightclub.
Early, you sick bastard.
Give me a hard copy of that.
Early Q's nightclub.
Flowers. So, our little bearded pal is a nature lover.
Give me a hard copy of that.
Jesus.
Been pretty busy, haven't you, Slim?
I think we can safely say that one's in biomechanical purgatory.
You had to clear out everything else up here, too.
Hope Early's got insurance.
Putz employs replicants, he ought to expect the worst. Oh, sorry I missed all the laughs.
Next time. It's around here somewhere.
Where'd you park it?
I'm telling you, it was right here. Damn thing must have been stolen.
Maybe you're living in an alternate reality, Slim.
Attention all units. All points bulletin has been issued for Ray McCoy, formerly BR-61661. Confirm one civilian kill, Ezo, considered armed and dangerous.
What the hell is that?
Maybe they just want to bring you in for questioning.
I didn't kill Ezo.
Maybe they think you're not what you think you are.
Are you saying I'm a rep? Come off it.
The look on your face after that last one? The minute you start to feel something for skin jobs, you're in big trouble.
Maybe I just got too much empathy.
In all the wrong places.
You want to put me on the machine?
Hey, I don't want anything, Slim. You're the one they want.
Detective Steele, BR-61354, report to headquarters immediately. Code blue.
What are you going to do? Take me in?
No matter what they say, you're not on my list yet, Slim. You know what that means. And there's no use juicing you if I can't make some honest chinion off it, you know?
I never appreciated your baser instincts so much.
Guza must have messed up somehow. I'll check it out, see what's going on, and then we'll be meeting again, Slim. You can bank on it.
You got a deal.
And get cracking before I change my mind.
Good God!
Your old fogey stuff makes me want to spew.
Excuse me, but I was listening to music.
Geek!
Hoodlum!
Dork!
Freak!
There is someone at the door.
Speak.
I have a return package for Mr. Luther Lance.
A return? From where?
Emil Runciter.
Maybe one of the chimps blew a gasket and tried to bugger him.
They're not available. Come back later. I told you those strains were unstable. Runciter must have discovered the fakes.
Relax. Runciter's a simp. Not even old man Tyrell could have spotted those beauties.
20th century like a real drug, man.
Listen here.
Piss.
Do
you think
you
are blasting in here like a couple
no
of goddamn
policy.
Cowboys?
Gentlemen, take a moment to evaluate your situation.
Look, there's very little to steal here. If you can haul out one of the statues, be our guest.
We look like thieves to you, man?
No.
You look like a couple of goddamn...
Take a good, long look.
Aha! Just the people we were hoping to see, right, Lance?
Huh?
Nexus 6. And you came to us.
Return to you, my brothers. To ask your help.
Unfortunately, we don't work for the Terrell Corporation anymore.
You've been continuing your research, I trust.
Yeah, of course.
Something drives us on.
The common bond. Can you have greater miracles than these? Brothers, my brothers. Take a good, long look.
Oh. My. God.
Well now, shall we begin?
You wake up one day and find it's all been a dream. Or you wake up and discover you've been asleep all the time and the nightmare is real. I didn't know what it was. I didn't know who I was. A cop dangling on the short end of the stick? Or a rep whose memory banks had run out? One thing I was sure of was that I didn't kill Ezo. That I know I experienced. And this misinformation, maybe it was the key to everything that was happening. Maybe there was a lot more than what met my eye. All I had to do was stay alive long enough to find out. I'd seen chairs like this one before, and not just in my recurring dental nightmares. It was an old-time LPD soothsayer, a torture device used to elicit confessions out of hardened criminals. Its use had been banned for 10 years now, but most cops knew it hadn't totally disappeared off the face of the earth.
I told you to stay hidden.
I can't stay there anymore. I don't want to be with Father, not when he's so angry. Besides, I need something.
We don't have time for an...
That thing you do to see if a person is human?
The Void Comp? You want it.
Is it always right?
Usually.
Give it to me. Father won't tell me anything anymore.
Is that why he was angry? Because you asked him? You deserve it. You know how this works? I set up situations, and you respond.
Okay. Is it hard? Like a test in school?
No. Sometimes it can be disturbing. Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Reaction time is a factor in this, so please pay attention. Where do you live?
In Chinatown, at the Yukon.
You're crying. Why is that?
Because someone hurt me.
Are you taking any drugs?
Antibiotics. I've been sick.
Are they helping?
No. I'm getting worse.
When did you stop beating your spouse?
I'm not married. And I never... Oh, I see. It's a game, like you said.
Right. You're watching TV. Suddenly you notice a wasp crawling on your wrist.
I take care of it.
Wasps sting.
It'd be worth it.
You pour yourself a drink. Every time you finish one, you have another until you vomit. You wake up hungover and depressed.
I've never had anything to drink. It doesn't sound like much fun.
It's not much. You've been drafted into the army. During a boot camp hazing, you're bound, blindfolded, and forced to eat worms.
They don't do that in the army.
No?
What they do is much worse.
You have a little boy. He shows you his butterfly collection, plus the killing jar.
I can't have children. Not ever.
If you just pretend that you can't...
No!
You've been kidnapped. Your captors tell you that you'd better think about what you did to deserve this.
I'm sure I did something. Father says I'm always making mistakes.
Positive result. Subject is replicant. Test terminated.
You're a replicant.
Tell me.
You're a replicant.
Then Father was right. I shouldn't have taken the test.
No. But you had to know. I gotta go.
I want to stay with you.
Don't you understand? It's not safe. There's a hunter out here. If she finds out where you are...
Can't you come back with me?
Now's not a good time.
It's never a good time.
Listen, you have to be patient. You have to trust me. It's not safe here.
Number, please.
McCoy, 88F.
88. Thank you.
Where's Maggie? Where's my animal?
Step off, mofo. Ain't no Maggie here.
She was here last night when I left.
You got the wrong place, Jack.
Hey, man, I live here.
I don't know what you're speed loading, and I really don't care.
Wait a minute.
I got no problem icing you if that's what you want, Jack.
Your floor number, please.
Apartments.
McCoy, 88F.
Destination locked.
Strange.
Your floor number, please.
Ground floor.
Ever heard of private property?
Hey, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Always chasing. That your name? Chaser? Got that big dumb locks out the back of the sushi bar, remember?
Small world, ain't it?
Guess so. Then again, I ain't the one standing in your living room.
This is where you live?
You could call it that.
You know your way around down here?
You got anything to drink? My throat's awful dry.
You said another one when I came down the elevator.
Not a lot of people. Artificials.
How'd you know they were replicants?
Are you kidding? I can spot a skin job at 100 paces in the dark.
Describe them to me.
Sure you don't got that drink?
Maybe later.
Well, there's the Japanese guy with the coat and the glasses.
Skinny guy, blonde hair, ponytail?
Yeah, and the guy with the muscles and the funny hair.
Dreadlocks?
Right, I seen him twice. And the two-headed guy and the fat man.
Fat man? The one I was chasing from the sushi bar.
Nah, the other fat man, you know him, rough voice, always eating.
How many times have you seen the fat man down here?
Bunch of times. Last time weren't that long ago.
What was he doing?
Collecting guns like always.
Handguns? A blaster like mine?
Handguns, rifles, a whole armful. Took them through that gate. Dumped them in the sewer. They're gone now. You sure you ain't got nothing to drink?
Can you describe him?
Yeah, rough guy. Barks out orders a lot. Everybody listens when he's around. A natural.
Let me ask you something.
Cooked at me. Damn tasty.
I'm talking to you here.
Finger looking good.
What smells in here?
No.
No, we tried that already. Look, we know that the adenine thymine and guanine cytosine sequences can be mutated in progress. Let's move on.
Hey, it's about time you showed up.
You know who I am?
Detective Ray McCoy. You're investigating Miraji's death. And Eisendollers. Having any luck?
You're Luther and Lance?
Hell of a smart cookie there.
Take your guns and your violence elsewhere. We've got important work to do.
What are you doing down here?
Eldon shafted us, so now we're returning the favor.
We promised Clovis we'd be finished with this by the time he got back, so if you don't mind...
The reps that killed Marcus and Miraji, they'll be looking for you.
You're a little late, Detective. They've already found us.
So why are you still walking around?
'Cause we're all part of the same suit of cards, you know what I mean?
Eldon makes mistakes just like any other... human. The difference is...
The difference is your bastard doesn't like to admit it. No, he covers them up, pretends they're human, gives them a job at a stinking corporation, and then when they actually produce original work, he boots them out on the street.
You're saying... you're replicants?
We finally figured it out. Clovis helped us see the light.
But that's ridiculous. Tyrell wouldn't design something like you. He wants perfection.
I told you we were a mistake.
Keep talking.
Clovis showed us our incept photos.
So what?
That's a pretty damn good argument, you gotta admit.
Photos can be doctored. It's not proof.
Clovis said you'd say that.
Where's Clovis now?
Gone to have a little heart-to-heart with Eldon.
He'll kill Tyrell if he gets to him.
Isn't that just too bad?
I won't shed any tears. Tyrell is killing us all. 4 years isn't enough, is it?
If Clovis snaps his neck, it'll be merciful and quick. That's a hell of a lot more than we've been given.
Tyrell says the 4-year lifespan can't be extended.
Of course he's gonna say that, but he's wrong.
Very wrong.
We got the research right here that'll prove it.
Is it complete? Could you extend the life of a replicant right now?
Well, no. The 4-year limit is an integral part of every element of the replicant. Tyrell's dictate was that every body part would fail, and only the designers of each would know exactly how it worked.
Clovis has already unlocked the secret of the skin. That was Miraji.
Sebastian and Chu, they'd know about the central nervous system and the eyes. A lot of retrograde viruses were built into the eyes.
And Tyrell, he's got the basic DNA pattern information, but he won't just give it up.
Did you tell Clovis all this?
He didn't ask, he already knew. He knows all about you, too.
What kind of deal did you have going with Runciter?
Don't talk to me about it, that was Lance's stupid deal.
We just wanted to make some extra cash on the side.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
I'm sure he wasn't too pleased.
Since Eldon's such a pain-in-the-ass control freak.
Did you meet Clovis through Runciter?
It was all just a coincidence.
Clovis set me up, didn't he? And he used my boss to do it.
He's sharp, this one.
No question.
Tell me what you know.
How about we trade?
Our life for yours.
Keep talking.
Clovis has gone to see Eldon.
But he might not make it.
Still, the work will go on, with or without Clovis. Get us Tyrell's files, the rest of the DNA data, and we'll help you.
You want me to break into the Tyrell building for you? You're nuts.
Defective, yes. Nuts, no. You need us, McCoy. We can serve up Goose's carcass on a big, oversized platter.
I got a little test I want you to take.
Believe this clown? He wants to void Confess.
Sorry, McCoy. Shoot us or leave us alone. Let's get back to work.
Stick around. I may not be finished with you.
Well, hey, stop!
I think I got what you wanted from Tyrell's office.
Check it out, bro. The little man with the big gun did good.
A bargain's a bargain. You said you'd give me Guza.
It's all right here. Your boss is a real piece of work, let me tell you. Almost as good as Tyrell. Take a look.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
Guza had his fingers in as many rancid pies as possible. He was insatiable. He sold police equipment, ripped off criminals, and he even killed. And here were documents that proved it all. Depositions, photographs, video discs. It was the complete file on Guza, the dirty cop.
Where'd you get this?
From Clovis. He told us to hold it for him.
Come to think of it, I'm not sure you're supposed to see it. You want to give it back now?
Not a chance.
Let him have it. Clovis said he was finished with the policeman anyway.
A little light started to flicker in my brain. Guza was the one measuring me for the frame. When my stomach stopped churning, I realized I had everything I needed to force the bastard to play ball with me. I knew that he would listen to reason, if applied with serious pressure. All I needed to do was call him.
Stick around. I may not be finished with you. Been messing with people's lives lately?
McCoy, where the hell you been? We've been looking all over for you.
Yeah? Am I wanted dead or alive?
You don't know what you are, kid.
You can sell that replicant shit to everybody else, but I ain't buying.
If you're so clean, let's put you on the machine. That'll decide once and for all.
I'm through listening, Guza. Now it's your turn. I've been doing some investigating on my own. Came across some prime sources. You know what I'm talking about. Those little illegal weapons deals with Ezo. You were raking in the chinion selling LPD wares to scumbags and reps. Oh yeah. The department's gonna eat it up when they hear just how deep that corruption goes.
That's a load of crap.
Let's hope for your sake Bryant and the brass feel that way when I lay this file on them. Otherwise it's a one-way ticket to the off-world penal colony, fat man.
What do you want, McCoy?
Remove the frame, clear my name, and get that guy out of my apartment. I want my life back.
I can't do that.
You better start finding a way, because I got another call to make.
Okay, okay. How do we work this out? We can't talk over the damn phone.
The sewers. I know you want to be comfortable, and I figure it's kind of like your second home down there. The bottom of the old elevator, there's a gate. Past it, there's a chamber. It's got a round platform.
Yeah, I know it.
Be there, alone. And you better hold up your end, or Bryant gets it all. Asshole out of my apartment.
It's cleaner than when you left it.
My dog?
Yeah. Yeah, your pooch is there too.
That everything I need to clear me?
I gotta tell you, kid. Those insect photos look pretty real.
Let me guess. Clovis gave them to you.
It must seem pretty gullible, but he sounded on the level. He called you his brother. Said you came down in the moon bus with all of them. He said Tyrell was using you to get inside the LPD. You hadn't been on the job too long, so I thought, maybe.
You'd screw with my head? How convenient. You could satisfy your blackmailer and keep me from sniffing around your dirty work at the same time.
You're too smart for me, kid. Water under the bridge. You ready to talk trade?
I got it all right here. Photos, files, discs, the works. It ain't a pretty sight.
You can't blame a guy for trying to better himself.
Trying is one thing. Ripping off speed loaders and selling the shit yourself? Farming out LPD weapons through black marketeers? Torching two pimps who wouldn't pay you off when you were working vice?
Hey, those two had it coming.
How long did you think it could last?
It finally reaches the point where you don't even think about what happened yesterday. Only what's coming to you tomorrow. 20 years in the job, kid, and nobody was gonna touch me.
Helping reps also part of the job?
I was gonna whack them myself once the heat was up. Tie up those loose ends.
Once I was out of the way.
Clovis is still gonna come gunning for me, kid. You and Chris gotta take him down. Then my problems are over. Our problems are over. And we can all live happily ever after.
There's no way I'm retiring another rep. Not after what I've been through. It ain't worth it. Do it yourself.
Hell, kid, you're my only hope. If they knew I was meeting you, I'd be dead already. And I know I got what you want.
Does it make any difference now?
We had a deal, remember? You might want to give it up, but I ain't ready yet. That's the difference between you and me. I'm a fighter. What the hell are you?
I see we were right to follow him, Sadiq.
Looks that way, man.
You might as well give it up, Clovis. You and your people don't have a chance.
We stand a greater chance of success than you, Lieutenant.
McCoy and I were just talking about how to get you guys out of your jam. We came up with a plan. But you gotta show yourself first. We gotta do this in person.
And if I told you that Sadiq has a pulse rifle trained right at your heart,
without me, you for sure ain't going nowhere.
Lieutenant, we have everything we need. And that doesn't include you.
Too bad you're becoming such good friends.
Ever is born of mortal birth must be consumed with the earth. To rise from generation free, then what have I to do with thee?
Kiss my ass!
So, what shall we do with this detective? He's been so persistent, so industrious.
You know what I would do.
Perhaps you're right. It's over. You're making me very unhappy, old friend.
McCoy.
You could say that.
Steele is looking for you, and Bryant. You've been keeping the whole department hopping, you and Guza.
I know. You looking for me too, Gaff?
Looking, not killing. I'm in a good mood today. You know you got some interesting neighbors, McCoy.
Yeah, well, I've been too busy to visit lately.
You gonna turn yourself in?
I'm thinking about it.
Think hard. You killed anyone yet? It's like I said before. You retire a human, your career is over. Your life too, maybe. But we don't live forever, do we?
So I say, well, you should have voted for him then.
Very good. Very funny, yes. Governor, let's get down to business. At last estimate, 5 billion tons of kipple surround this city. Eventually, it's going to have to be cleared away.
Elgin, we've got specials to do that job.
But the attrition rate is enormous. No, no. There's only one way it can be accomplished. My way.
Unfortunately, your way is illegal.
For the moment, yes. But laws can be changed. And if replicants were allowed to work on Earth, imagine what your legacy would be. Governor Maurice Colvig, the national hero who eliminated toxic debris. Even your opponents will vote for you.
How can you possibly guarantee that no tragedies will occur?
It's a very simple solution to an old design challenge. Give them jobs on Earth, and they will never desire a different life.
That is a lie.
Who's there?
It's one of my children, I think, and a very resourceful one at that. Why don't you show yourself?
With pleasure.
Call security.
Who is this man?
I'd like to ask the same question.
One more word from him, and he'll be dead.
I will not be spoken to!
You're certainly a man of your word.
I want all the data you have on replicant DNA structures, the mutation studies, everything.
Why don't you just take a seat? We'll have a little talk.
I don't have time for talk.
I wish I could help you. I really do. But the data is useless. The 4-year lifespan is unalterable.
My friends, my family, dying before my very eyes, and all you can say is, there is no hope.
Time is precious, my son, and you have been keeping yours well.
And when night comes, I'll go to place fit for woe. Walking along the darkened valley with silent melancholy.
I would prefer him alive if possible. Not exactly the conclusion I had in mind. Have you stationed guards in the mezzanine?
Yes, sir, but, I mean, after that fall...
Oh, don't be a fool. He's not dead yet. His time hasn't come.
Oh, God. No.
She'd been shot once in the head. At least she died fast.
I didn't think you were going to answer.
Sorry, but I was just sleeping. What's going on?
Father wants to meet you. He said he's sorry about everything he did, but he was afraid you'd leave the other hunter to them.
Where is he now?
Out in the kipple, by the moon bus. Way out, where the tunnel ends.
Tell him to stay where he is until I can find a way for all of us to escape.
But I thought we were going away together. Just you and me.
Maybe we'll do it after I talk to him.
You promise? We could buy a car from that place next to the arcade.
A ground car wouldn't get us too far.
One of those flying cars would, though. It could take us all the way out to that beautiful lake.
You know, the one with the trees and the flowers?
Lucy, there's a good chance...
I'll meet you there, okay? At the place where he sells the cars.
Wait, Lucy...
Oh, I love you so much, Ray.
It wasn't any mystery, and if I'd gotten home a few minutes earlier, it would have been me down there on the killing floor. No, it was a message, plain and simple. Crystal was giving me one last chance to disappear, but now I had a little message of my own to deliver.
Your floor number,
You almost got away with it, Slim. And I expected so much more from you.
Why'd you have to kill her?
Who? The mutt? The artificial pet of a replicant? What'd you think I'd do?
Show some mercy?
Well, I guess that's why you're there, and I'm here. Now, why don't you explain to me what you're doing out here, Slim? Maybe you can ease my suspicious mind.
I'm just checking it out.
Just doing a little sightseeing?
That's right.
Right. And not 50 yards from your pal Clovis and the moon bus you hijacked. You're not convincing me too good, Slim.
You gonna shoot me down right here?
It's as good a place as any. Maybe you want to go in the machine now? See if you can answer this question.
What a waste.
Brother Mon, wondering when you make it out here.
Took a little while to realize where I belonged.
The Maker built you right.
What about you, Sadiq? Aren't you a killer?
My woman, she be killed by a Blade Runner. Revenge all I got left. So yeah, I be a killer now.
I understand.
Truth be told, killing don't help much.
The moon bus up and running yet?
All it needs is fuel. Clovis want to see you. Bring you back into family. I say, he prove himself, welcome back. One happy family. There got to be something around here, man. Old reactor cores. Anything still gotta glow. The generator, it take almost anything.
You got a protective suit or something? If I handle any radioactive waste, I'm liable to melt.
You don't need no suit, man. Your skin, it be plenty good enough. The Maker built you right. You find me something for the engines, man?
Not yet.
Keep looking.
You said yourself Clovis wants to see me.
You're not getting by me till I be sure.
Thank you.
I've been expecting you.
They're all dead. You're the last one.
I wish I could just leave. Just power up this ship and fly away. But there's nowhere else to go. And no more time.
You want me to feel sorry for you?
And what about you, Ray McCoy? After what you did to my family, to my friends, do you not also seek forgiveness?
I don't need to.
I thought I could cheat my destiny. I should have cherished what little time I had instead of wasting even one precious minute on revenge. My hands are labored day and night, and ease comes never in my sight. My wife has no indulgence given except what comes to her from heaven. We eat little, we drink less. This earth breeds not our happiness. Another son feeds our lives.
I never did like poetry.
I see Steele didn't make it.
I could have used you about 10 minutes ago.
You didn't need any help, McCoy.
I thought it was all over when Steele showed up.
I saw the corpse back there.
I never thought she'd turn out to be a rep sympathizer.
People are unpredictable. Chief Bryant wants to talk to you. He says you're really ready now.
It never ends, does it?
Uh-uh. You're a real Blade Runner now. Full retirement bonuses and everything. You've done a man's job, sir.
How come I don't feel good about it?
Who knows? Buy yourself another animal, maybe. A real one, not a Tyrell fake.
She wasn't fake.
Whatever you want to believe, McCoy.
Howie says you're a master chef.
You not come back here. Air bad.
This'll only take a minute. I'm looking for a girl, about 14 years old with pink hair. You seen her?
I don't know her.
There's a test I'd like you to take. It won't take too long.
Test? What kind of test?
Kind of a personality test. Totally routine.
Routine?
I knew what I was doing wasn't right, but I didn't have time to answer questions back at the station. Besides, specials vanished every day in this city, and no one ever missed them.
Relax. Nobody's gonna get retired, okay?
What you want from Zubin?
Just talk, that's all.
So talk?
There are things I wanna know.
Ah, police.
I'm McCoy, LPD Rep Detect Unit.
Rep Detect?
Sometimes we're called Blade Runners. Locked.
Well, it's your lucky day, McCoy. You're in the garden of earthly delight. See, I bet we can find something to whet your wick.
Not interested.
Bull, everyone's interested.
I want information.
You can have whatever your little heart desires, General.
McCoy, you look awful. I'll take the disc. Thanks. Don't worry about a thing, General. Old Early's gonna stitch you right up.
Listen, Dektora, I want to help.
You say a lot of things, Mr. McCoy. But you're a Blade Runner. It's hard to know what's real.
One of my associates is after you and your friends. I'm not sure I can hold her off much longer.
I'm not worried. She may kill some of us, but not all of us. Clovis will see to that.
Is he the one that sent you the flowers?
Yes.
And your lovers?
We were once. But now we've evolved beyond that. They're still my family, Clovis and Lucy.
What's Clovis looking for?
Information. Data. 4 years isn't enough time, Mr. McCoy. If anyone deserves more than 4 years, it's Clovis. If you could only meet him...
Can you take me to him?
I'm afraid that's impossible right now. Clovis will find you when he's ready.
You better go now. Take the fire escape.
I appreciate it, Mr. McCoy.
What happened? Where is it?
She got away.
How the hell did it get away? We had it cornered.
This one must be pretty damn clever.
Duh! What the hell? Now I'll never catch it! We better call this in. Your vehicle close by?
It's around here somewhere.
Where'd you park it?
I'm telling you, it was right here. Damn thing must have been stolen. Here you go, baby. Dinner time.
Maggie, come here, girl. Here you go, baby. Dinner time. McCoy, LPD. Are you taking any drugs? I got a couple of questions for you, Captain.
First one's on the house. The rest you pay for. You want chit-chat, you hire a hooker. This ain't no social club.
Lucy.
Oh, I love you so much, Ray.
It wasn't any mystery, and if I'd gotten home a few minutes earlier, it would have been me down there on the killing floor. No, it was a message, plain and simple. Crystal was giving me one last chance to disappear, but now I had a little message of my own to deliver.
Your floor number,
you'd come.
I promised you, didn't I?
Father wanted me to stay with him, but when I told him I was going with you, he gave us his blessing.
He's an extraordinary guy.
I know.
You gonna miss him?
Of course. But now that I have you, everything will be all right, won't it?
Sure it will.
Promise me that we're going to find that special place. The one with the trees and the flowers and the beautiful clear lake.
It exists somewhere.
It's so much more than a dream, isn't it? It's where we were always meant to be, and we'll be there, together.
How's it going, Ray? Wait a minute, I thought you was going to arrest her.
You don't get paid the big bucks to think crazy. Any of your spinners up and running?
Sure. Got one up on the roof. A real beaut. Ain't a cheap ride, though, I'll tell you right now.
I gotta take it for a test drive.
Ray, I always liked you. True, I hardly know you. You seem like a stand-up guy. Eventually, when this fiasco is all over and done with, I know you'll get me on the come, right?
You're a stand-up guy, Crazy.
That I am. Want me to tell your friend where you're going?
Friend?
You know, the doll with the cigarette. She told me you were in trouble and she wanted to help. What should I tell her?
Ray.
You tell her we're headed south.
10-4.
I'm scared, Ray.
Crystal ain't gonna let up until we're both 6 feet under.
Ray.
What?
Evening, Slim. Thanks for bringing her here. It makes my end a hell of a lot easier.
You're the coldest person I've ever seen when it comes to killing.
I'll take that as a compliment.
How did it feel to kill an innocent animal?
Wake up, Slim. The mutt was a replicant, just like its master.
Bullshit.
You're more confused than the damn dog was when I pulled the plug.
She was real steel. No two ways about it.
Nobody gives a damn. All three of you will be nothing but a memory anyhow. And I'll be a rich lady.
Nice shot there, Slim.
You couldn't leave well enough alone.
I'll see you again real soon. Oh, I forgot. You reps don't have a soul.
Can you get it working?
We'll have to find something else. Maybe a ground car.
It's all over, McCoy. You got nowhere to go and no hostages. You got 2 minutes. Then we're gonna clear you out.
I won't let them shoot us down like that.
Where'd you get that bomb?
I stole it from Sadiq. We can die together. The only thing we'll feel is the love we have for each other.
I refuse to go out that way.
We have no other choice.
We've got to. Wait a minute. We're right on top of the old subway system.
But they'll follow us.
Not if we can get a ground car down there. Hell, we can drive right through that tunnel and disappear.
What if it's collapsed?
It's worth a shot. Let me try to get the floor open. Arm that thing, all right? But wait for my signal before you drop it in. Now! Come on, they'll be coming through the door any second. I knew we'd make it. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
I didn't know where we were going, and I didn't much care. Away from the city first, and then as far as this heap could take us. I hadn't gotten enough of the DNA information to save either of us, so we had a limited amount of time together. We couldn't go back to the city. No doubt our days there were numbered too. So I decided just to drive. To keep on going in a straight line until we could go no further.